This has turned out to be a fiery race, especially after Ayako acrimoniously lost to Obado during the ODM party primaries that were held in April this year. The intensity of their rivalry, witnessed on their campaign trails, manifest by cases of violence that have left their wake several people dead and scores of others injured. Only last Friday, over 30 people sustained serious injuries when supporters of the duo clashed during a Nasa rally.
It's on both matters.
It's on both matters.
It is such a crime that saw the duo appear before the Wafula Chebukati-led IEBC disciplinary committee, with Obado accusing Ayako of instigating violence and destroying his campaign materials.
I came with supporters here who were beaten on that Sunday and also on the 30th of last month when NASA had a mammoth rally in Migori County. Initially thought you'd disrupt that rally, but upon sensing that the crowd was so huge for him to disrupt, he waylaid people on the way.
In his defense, Ayako denied the claims and urged the committee to dismiss the case. The committee, however, turned down the request and instead gave him until next week, Tuesday, to respond to the claims.
The case will proceed and we shall determine it on the merits. If there's no evidence, of course, we shall dismiss. If there's evidence, we shall make our findings.
He is running scared, and he wants us to be kept here for time without end, to waste our time instead of beating him down there. He also wants, at best, that we be sanctioned, because he was sanctioned, and I do not see any basis for this.
The electoral body is also expected on Tuesday to rule on whether Kawira Mwangaza, an independent candidate for Meru woman representative seat, is using a vernacular TV station owned by her family to allegedly spread propaganda. The disciplinary committee gave Meru woman representative Florence Kajuju 6 more days to seek information from the Communication Authority of Kenya on the content being aired by the TV station. Kajuju accuses a competitor of using the media station to spread distorted information contrary to the law.
Article 34 of the Constitution, anybody who uses media stations to influence persons because she has political interest, then the connection must be shown to the commission so that they are able to make a decision, because there is no other TV station that broadcasts the information that is distorted and manipulated other than Baita TV.
She has shifted the whole pray to other issues rather than going straight kwa ile ambaye alikuwa amenistaki. Kwa hivyo kwangu namshukuru Mungu kwa sababu nimeona ameogopa kesi endelee.
Kevin Washira, Channel One News.